Tell us about this mission.
Yes, speaking of routine, it was the seventh operational crewed flight for SpaceX through NASA's commercial crew program. They hold an ongoing contract to send astronauts to the International Space Station for the space agency. And this crew was a very international crew. There was a NASA astronaut, a European astronaut, a Japanese astronaut, and a Russian cosmonaut. So it really just kind of encapsulates what NASA is trying to do with these launches by sending up partner astronauts and NASA astronauts.
What's SpaceX going to be doing with all of this activity as well, Loren?
Well, now that they've launched their latest crew, it's time for the recent crew that they launched up roughly 6 months ago to come home. So in a week, Crew 6 will be returning to Earth in their own Crew Dragon capsule after they greet and make the new incoming crew feel right at home.
Yeah, Loren, you broke some news Friday that Starship, the explosion in April, had big environmental impact. Quickly summarize your reporting.
Yeah, so there's quite a lot going in space, but plenty going on down here on Earth as well. So a lot of people might remember the SpaceX Starship test launch in April. Well, we did a Freedom of Information Act request looking at, information that we could gather between SpaceX officials and the Fish and Wildlife Service in the aftermath of that launch, because it was quite explosive and it was quite destructive. And then we got 1,100 pages of emails and photos, giving us a really candid look at how those officials with the Fish and Wildlife Service were kind of agog at what happened after that flight.